Stuff which I'm using is once the Sinfon mattress against sliding, then the Thermarest X-Therm in large and max, so I have the square version. My winter sleeping bag is Feathered Friends Ebex, which should be good down to minus 17 Celsius apparently, but naja, we will see this. And this is just my pillow with additional clothes in it. And the additional clothes which I brought for this trip is once wool socks. And if I would get cold, I have some expat down socks as well, two in here. Another sun hoodie above. Yeah, and these ones are just like from the swimming pool, some plastic things. And I also always have an additional underwear. And in winter, I have the ones with long legs, so they go basically above the knee. I think it's just brilliant. And what I really like about this one is, this is von Hyperlite Mountain Gear, so I can turn it inside out. I just use it as a stuff sack, but it's not a compression bag. And then I have here like a really soft fleece liner. It's really nice, because my problem was with I need this one for the night. My problem was with a Trichology pillow, or generally with air pillows, that when you sleep, when it's cold, then your pillow is really cold, and I just don't like it. Yeah, I was not the biggest fan of it, so I'm pretty pleased with this one, because the clothes I anyway need to use, I mean, a really cheap option to this is what I used before really often, was just a stuff sack, a normal one which I had, and put a buff around it with the stuff in. But yeah, I got this one, I really like it. And I have also, which are not in yet because I put them later on, some long johns, yeah, which I can wear then underneath these ones. And these ones are just three layer Gore-Tex trousers. They go up to here. It's really nice. And you might have recognized that I use a different sleeping bag, not any longer the Criterion 750 Traveler. And this is to do with a tent I'm sleeping in, because it's a single wall tent, and when you sleep and you wriggle around in the night, you can't avoid that every so often you touch just the wall. Yeah, and every so often you have just the condensation in it. And the outer shell of the sleeping bag is more or less water resistant, so it doesn't get soaked. So this is the reason why I use this one, even when the pack size is ridiculous with 20 liters, and the Criterion, for example, has only 12 liters. And this is also the reason why I bought myself a C2 Summit Event compression bag, 20 liters, and I can bring him down to 15 or so. Still a third of my backpack, yeah, when I go out in winter, but yeah, this is what it is. Then I also have here my winter jacket I brought with me. And the winter jacket I'm using is a Montbel Alpine, I think, parka or so. Yeah, it's this green one. It's an absolute beautiful jacket. It's quite big, yeah. So I can have my synthetic one. This is a micro puff I can wear underneath. So basically, this is what I have for warmth. Then other things I brought is some nuts, Jelly Babies, M&M's. Yeah, the little pump. I quite really enjoy this with the pump, so I don't need to use a pump sack. And I really like by this Flextail tiny pump, is it? I don't know. But you have also a light, I think, which is really handy for filming. But this is not really affecting, I think, too many of us. Then I brought my headlight. My for winter is just the Phoenix HM65RT. And the reason is just that I don't need to worry with charging anything, or so I know that the battery life is plenty for two nights or three nights out. So This is what I brought with me. Then for the worst case, I brought two heat pads. I have them in for, I don't know for how long. Yeah, coffee. Yeah, an energy bar for tomorrow for breakfast. Yeah, and then just basically cooking things. And my little food pouch with a, yeah, with a pasta bolognese for later. And I used actually this time, usually I do 125 grams and this portion is 150 grams. So it's a bit bigger that I have a little bit more energy. And I also brought, this is 125 milliliter of fuel. I assume I need only 60, so I have plenty to spare. And in my pocket, I have it like all day, just in this pocket, is the water filter. I brought him, but there's really little use of it. You saw me trying to break the ice and then I just collected the snow. And here I have just a small Nalgene, a big Nalgene with water, and I also brought, you have seen this already, my bladder, which is my snow storage for later on. Yeah, and that's it basically what I all brought. Ah, no, I brought also some waterproof gloves. These are some seal skins, which are basically my working gloves or anything, because these ones, they can transform. I have them really long, they are some mammoth ones. Yeah, they can transform into some mittens. And you can't beat mittens for warmth, but they are just fleece, it's like a polar tech thing. So they're really, really nice and handy, and you have your fingers out in access, and in my experience, the front bits of the fingers are not getting so quick cold, so you have the fine movement with your fingers when you want to do something, which is, I think, really nice, and you can attach them at the rear. Yeah, but this is basically all the stuff I brought. Obviously, my stripy hat. Yeah, and then some camera stuff, and here I have also more camera stuff, like one light, another light, cables and a power bank.